see you. We're going to start this morning with a number of songs that have been in your culture. The first one, to God be the glory. Welcome to sing along with us.
Thank you.
yet we know we will always be safe in His care. We remember that the cross is the sign of salvation, and with the cross we have been saved. So we revere the cross, the old rugged cross. We'll cling to the old rugged cross and exchange someday for a crown.
I'm
what do we do? Well, the saints go marching in, don't they?
Sweet harmony, come out for your wandering feet. I'm gonna keep making music that God wants to sing. Jesus is better. I'm gonna turn on the sounds that you drag people down.
Yeah, go for it.
So, when we sing out of tune, there's moments in for children like you and me. Go tell me the world is a wholesome place, then it might as well just be good. To the women do.
Heart.
And it's about thankfulness, it's about respect, it's about acknowledgement, it's about wonder and awe. You know, a few months ago, somebody said, you know, I worked very hard. It's really good to be appreciated. It would make me feel better. Somebody just said, I appreciate you. And I said, that's such a wonderful lesson. Because you are, but how often do we stop and just say it? And it means so much. I appreciate you. God, we appreciate you and we love you. Your love that you give, it's ever flowing, it's ever abundant, and it's love that's unconditional, and it's served with mercy and grace. What an amazing gift. And it's for everyone. It's not just for me or the choir. Tremendous lesson for us. So let us as adults remember those feelings of excitement that we had when we were children and recapture that jubilation when we think about and when we would praise God. Thank you, children, for that lesson. And the reading today comes from Psalm 148. It's verses 1 through 14. And we hear, this actually is a hymn. And when you hear it, think of it as a hymn being sung to the community. It calls the entire creation to join in praise of the Lord. Not just Jim and myself and Dot, all creation to join in praise, singing praises to God. Psalm 148, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise Him in the heights. Praise Him, all His angels. Praise Him, all His hosts. Praise Him, sun and moon. Praise Him, all you shining stars. Praise Him, your highest heavens and your waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for He commanded and they were created. He established them forever and ever. He fixed their bounds which cannot be passed. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps. Fire and hail, snow and frost, stormy wind, fulfilling His command. Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth, young men and women alike, old and young together. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for His name alone is exalted. His glory is above earth and heaven. He has raised up a horn for His people. Praise for all His faithful, the people of Israel who are close to Him. Praise the Lord. God, we thank You for this reading and ask Your blessings upon it. Thank You, God.
Thank you. And I'm sorry if people have different beliefs, but I just can't see not rejoicing and clapping. We're not clapping for a person, we're clapping for God.
Absolutely.
One of my favorite spiritual heroes and an inspiration for ministry has always been St. Francis of Assisi. I love that he was so passionate about life. He was different. It reminded me of Pentecost. They probably said, he's drunk. He's so joyful. You know? He was so passionate about ministry and also about God's creation and especially animals. That's one thing I think, the reason I relate to him so much, is many of us are so passionate about the animals in our family life. We will be holding a blessing of the animals here in October, actually, which is going to be a tremendous event, and even dressing them up for poor children. My cat, I dress up and put it on Facebook, and here we go, that cat is not happy. But after 15 years, I thought she'd get used to it. So, well, anyway, one thing St. Francis instituted in his community was that on Christmas, I love this, on Christmas, he declared that in his community that all the animals would be given twice their normal food. Twice the normal food. You mean I can go to the Georgian buffet twice? Yes. I love it. Twice their normal food. It showed about his awareness and his connection with animals and, you know, the compassion and all that we learn from them. But we can't hear Psalm 148 without recalling the picturesque twist that St. Francis put on it, on his images and his canticle of the creations. With deep affection, he speaks of the heavenly bodies as family, brother, son, sister, moon. But Francis didn't speak adoringly about flowers. He spoke to the flowers. Hi, Fern, good morning, how are you? They would think we're drunk. But good morning, he didn't speak about it, he spoke to them. What a difference. There's a huge difference there. When I walked in this morning, there's beautiful flowers right in our door of our church, and it'd be easy to walk right past them, but I said, good morning. Took a picture of them, they're on Facebook. So, but he spoke to the flowers and encouraged them as though they could understand to praise the Lord. When walking by a field, he would turn and address stalks of corn, hilly meadows, a running brook, and even the wind rustling through the trees, exhorting them to serve and praise God joyfully. What a way to live, to be that connected to the divine around us. But what we might not realize is that in the winter of 1224, the year 1224, 1225, he was physically miserable. He was nearly blind. His lungs were riddled with tuberculosis. He was in constant pain. He was exhausted from the effects of fasting and rigorous travel. There were mice that had infested his house. He had gaping wounds in his hands and in his feet and in his side. And the only medical attention he could get was of a medieval sort. And, you know, that wasn't very good and probably did him more harm than good. Professionally, he was stricken. And the friars, they were bickering. So he's in the midst of this chaos, this seemingly chaos all around him. And you would think he would get disheartened, wouldn't you? Emotionally, he was drained. And instead of sinking into despondency, instead of pleading with God, God, please fix all these broken things around me, God, he did something different. He pleaded with the Lord not to cure him, but to help him bear his illnesses patiently. Because what is healing? People ask that all. How come this person was healed and this person wasn't physically? But I invite us this morning to think about what is true healing. And here's an example here. God, I'm not praying, let your will be done. I may be healed physically or not, but help me to bear this illness patiently. What a difference. And God's reply was, Francis was told in spirit he would receive a great and precious treasure and a promise. And God says, be glad and rejoice in your illness and troubles because as of now, you, Francis, you are secure as if you were already in my kingdom, God tells him. You are secure as if you were already in my kingdom. All that chaos around you, it doesn't have the power over you like my love does. And he said yes to it. What an invitation it looked that the same Lord gives us, the invitation to trust him, to know Jesus, to experience, as Jim Sargent says, glimpses of God in our lives on this planet, and the divine during our earthly journey, surrounded and embraced by the Holy Spirit, and embrace the Lord and praise his holy name. Let us lay down our burdens down by the riverside. Amen. In Psalm 149, he gives us further instruction. Let them praise his name with dancing, so it's okay. I don't care what you say. Making melody, well, that's questionable, but we'll talk about later. To him, and with what? With what Fred has in his hands? With tambourines. So amen to that. Let them praise the Lord.
Oh, my God.
when she does this, she's getting serious. Hold my hand, gospel style.